Good morning, students. Today we are going to understand about the topic Kingdom Protista. As you already know, in the previous lecture you have studied about the Kingdom Monera, and so this is the next kingdom, Kingdom Protista. Basic features, you know that they are unicellular eukaryotes. This is special feature of them that they are unicellular eukaryotes. Means they have single nucleus inside them and they are single celled and they are eukaryotes. Now we are discussing in this table the four types of protists, because the fifth protist, which is the protozoa, we have already discussed as a table in the previous lecture. So only here we are considering the four left groups. So chrysophytes, dinoflagellates, euglenoids and slimoids. So number one feature is habitat, where they are found. Chrysophytes are generally found in fresh water, that can be marine, that can be fresh water, that is rivers, streams, and marine water, that can be oceans and salty water. Now their dinoflagellates are also occurring in both fresh water and marine water. Euglenoids mostly occur in stagnant water, and slime molds occur in dead decaying matters. Now nutrition. The chrysophytes, they are also given the name of diatoms, and they are also given name of photosynthetic organisms. Why? Because they have pigments. They are also called golden brown algae of oceans. They are also known as jasmines. So therefore they are photosynthetic in their nutrition, because they have pigment, they can do photosynthesis, they can synthesize their food on their own. Here dinoflagellates are also photosynthetic in nature. Now coming to the eublenoids, they are photosynthetic in the presence of light, and they are predator in absence of light. That means in dark they will be predatory in their habit, nutrition, and in the light it will be photosynthetic. Now slime mold, they are saprozoic, means they derive nutrition from dead matter. They digest dead matter and then they get nutrition. So they are saprozoic. Now coming to the cell wall. So two thin overlapping cell walls are present. Shells like substance are present. Here I have drawn one top cover and bottom lid is cover or lid, and the bottom base is there. Just like soap box, so that fit in each other. Such kind of cell walls are present in the diatoms or chrysophytes, which is a characteristic feature. And it is embedded with silica. Silica is present in the cell walls. Now this silica is indestructible, cannot be destroyed. So it, after the death of the organism, it keeps on accumulating and forming the diatomaceous earth on the ocean floor. This is having various features, like it can be used for filtration, it can be used for the polishing of certain materials. Here cell wall is of stiff cellulose plates, is present on the dinoflagellates, and two flagella are most common feature of this dinoflagellates. Thin proteinaceous pellicle layer is present as a covering. In eublenoid there is a thin protein layer, flexible layer, which is present on the euglena, and one long flagella is present on the euglena. So this the covering is just proteinaceous, made of protein. This is the important feature of euglena. Now slime molds, they are having chitinous, or we can say fungus like cell wall, made up of glycoproteins and glycolipids. Cell wall is made up of glycoproteins and glycolipids. Now coming to common name, they are known as diatoms, golden brown algae, desmids. They are known as diflagellates, protists, because they two flagella, one transverse flagella and one longitudinal flagella is the important feature. So one transverse flagella and one longitudinal flagella is present in the dinoflagellates. Here eublenoids, this is the link between the protists and plant kingdom, because eublena is only member And the euglena can prepare its own food because of the presence of chloroplasts in it. And in the dark, it also can have the predatory habit, like it can do phagocytosis. Now, here, this is the fungal protist. Common name is fungus-like protists. Now, coming to the examples, Navicula, Leurosigma. These are the two examples of chrysophytes, and many other are examples you can see on the internet also, Navicula, Leurosigma. And dinoflagellates is Nautiluca and Goniolips. These are two examples which are mentioned here. Goniolips, out of which is causing red tides. In the ocean, when it rapidly multiplies, it becomes, the sea appears red in color because of its presence. And it can also cause the poisoning of fishes because of releasing of certain poisons. And if this fish is eaten by human, we can also get poisoned. So, euglena is the example of euglenoid, and plasmodium slime mold are the examples of the slime molds. Now, coming to the next, we will now discuss about the fungi. So, what are the general features of fungi? Fungi are the unicellular or multicellular non-photosynthetic organisms, and they are growing in the humid environment and on dead matter. So, they are dead matter, something which is deriving nutrition from dead matter is saprotrophic. Habitat is that damp place means where moisture and humidity is present, and mostly they are terrestrial and few are aquatic. They can be found in the, even in the water. They can be symbiotic. Example is lichens. In lichens, you all know that lichens is a combined association of algae and fungi, and mycorrhiza, fungi in the roots. The fungal roots, it means mycorrhizae. Rhizae is related to roots. R for rhizae, R for roots. Myco is related with the fungus. So, fungi in the roots, big roots. So, this is also the habitat. Now, coming to structure. The body of the fungi consists of thread-like structures. Thread-like structures are known as hyphae. And hyphae, when it becomes network, then we give a new name, mycelium. Network is of hyphae is known as mycelium. Now, hyphae can be two types. Without compartment means separation, so it will become multinucleate. So this type of hyphae will be known as aseptic hyphae. And if the hyphae is having separation, for example, if I draw a hyphae here, and if I draw various compartments, and only single nucleus is present and other organelles are present, cytoplasm is present. So this kind of hyphae having separation is known as septate hyphae. So, septate hyphae can be uninucleate, septate hyphae can be binucleate, septate hyphae. In some fungi, there are two nucleus in each septa. So, there I have written uni and binucleate, dicotyl, also called septa. Separation is known as septa. Now, cell wall, you all know it is made up of chitin cell wall. So, reproduction. Reproduction can be of three types, one vegetative, two asexual, and three sexual. Vegetative by budding and fragmentation. You know, in yeast, this is an example of budding. So, and fragmentation, when one hyphae divide into two, this long hyphae divide into two, then we say that it is fragmentation. So, separation or splitting of the hyphae by fragmentation also causes the vegetative reproduction in fungi. Asexual reproduction is by forming the spores inside a ball-like structure at the top of the hyphae called as sporangiospores or zoospores if they are movement by flagella. Sexual is by fusion of gametes, and sexual reproduction cycle has three steps. First, the two opposite hyphae will meet, so their cytoplasm will meet, plasmogamy. Then their nucleus also fuse, karyogamy. Then after birth, the two nucleus fission which will be there, zygote will undergo meiosis. Meiosis means reduction, division to form the spores. Now we will move to the next, which is the division. Divisions are four divisions of kingdom fungi. I have made a table so that it is easy to learn for you. So features are, number one is mycelium structure. And number one, what division is phycomycetes, ascomycetes, Gensidiomycetes and Deuteromycetes, these are four divisions. So number one, mycelium, algal fungi is phycomycetes, ascomycetes is sac fungi, basidiomycetes is club fungi, and deuteromycetes is imperfect fungi. This is the common name. Mycelium structure, aseptic sinusitic mycelium is there in phycomycetes. Branch or septate mycelium is there in ascomycetes. Branch septate mycelium in basidio, branch septate in deutero. Now coming to habitat, it is only found in aquatic and also terrestrial. So both places it is found, aquatic as well as terrestrial. It is mostly ascomycetes is mostly saprophytic and parasitic, causing various plant diseases, animal diseases, and it is also saprotrophic and parasitic. Basidiomycetes is both dead decaying organic matter and growing on dead matter and parasitic also. And deuteromycetes is saprotrophic and parasitic. Even it is last member is also saprotrophic and parasitic. Reproduction asexually by zoospores or apenospores. So here in phycomycetes, zoospores and apenospores are formed. And here conidia called spores are asexual spores are conidia and sexual spores are ascospores. Two types of spores can be found, asexual conidia and sexual ascospores. Vegetative reproduction is by fragmentation and sexual reproduction forming the spores are basidiospores. Here asexual and vegetative reproduction is by only seed. This is important point that asexual is only seed, reproduction is only seed. Here fruiting body is sporangium, and here the fruiting body is known as conidiophores and ascocarp. Here the fruiting body is known as basidium, and deuteromycetes the fruiting body is known as conidiophores. These are the fruiting bodies. Example, fruiting body means that spore producing body. Spore producing body or structure. Spore producing structure is known as fruiting body. So fruiting body is called here sporangium, here ascocarp, basidium and conidiophore. Examples, here mucor is example, rhizopus is example, aspergillus is example, penicillium is example of ascomycetes, agaricus is example, mushroom, agaricus is common name is mushroom. So these are club fungi are also known as mushrooms general. So agaricus is an example. Deuteromycetes is trichoderma is an example. Alternaria is an example. So this was all about the kingdom protista and kingdom fungi. In the next lecture we are going to understand the other topics of this remaining topics of this chapter. Till here you have to do the complete the notes and also study the same parts from the NCERT. Thank you.